Transfers are printed designs that allow you to add intricate markings and patterns onto your miniatures, and in this video we're going to show you how to apply them. Now, a miniature that we're going to use for example is a Leman-Russ battle tank, which I've got just here, and what we're going to do is add a marking onto the side of its turret. Now, to apply transfers you need to gather a few things before you begin. First of all, you need a way to cut them out from the backing sheet that they're printed on, and in this case I'm going to be using a knife and a cutting mat, but you could use scissors if you wanted to. You're also going to need two different kinds of varnish, and I've got them here. First of all, you'll need Ardcoat, which is a gloss varnish, and you're also going to need Storm Shield, which is a matte varnish. And we're going to be starting out with Ardcoat, because what this gloss varnish will do is give a really smooth surface that the transfer can adhere to very easily. So what you need to do first of all is make sure you give the varnish a really good shake, just like any other paint, to make sure it's nicely mixed. And then the brush I'm going to be using to apply it is a medium shade brush. And you can see on this palette, I've also painted on a square of grey paint there, just so you can clearly see what I'm doing here. Now, it's a good idea to put the varnish onto a palette before you apply it, just to test to see how thick it is, because it might be a little bit too thick straight out the pot. And if it is, you can always add a touch of water to it to thin it down like this. But you want it brought down to about that kind of consistency, so it's really thin as you apply it to the miniature. Then all you need to do is decide where the transfer is going to go. In this case, it's going to be on this panel on the side of the turret here. And all you do is paint the varnish completely over this area. Now, the reason why you want to do the complete area here is because you want to avoid later on having a line appearing where the varnish is and where it isn't. You see just there like that. And if you paint the whole area, it helps hide that. So just look for a natural edge, for example, the edge of this panel here, and go all the way up to that. Once that gloss varnish is completely dry, you're then ready for the next step, which is to cut out the transfer. And for this, what I'm going to do is go for one of these lightning bolt designs just here. Now, this is where I'm going to use my knife. And remember, if you're also using a knife and you're a youngster, you'll want to get an adult to do this part for you because, of course, the blade is really sharp. But you could alternatively use some scissors if you wanted to. But I need to start cutting this one out. So I'm just going to cut across here, then across here, down the side just there, and finally down here as well. And there we go. So now the transfer is starting to come loose, and we're now ready for the fiddly part. First of all, of course, be sure to put the cap back on your knife so it's nice and safe, and then we need to try and pick up the little transfer. So here we go, just need to pick that up there like that, and then put it onto some tissue, because now we're ready to make the transfer start to move. For this, all you need to do is soak it with some water. So using your medium shade brush once more, load it up with plenty of water and give the transfer a good soaking on that tissue paper. Once you've done so, leave the transfer for about 30 seconds. After about 30 seconds, use your brush to just poke the transfer and see if it moves. And if it does, like this one's doing just here, then we know we're ready to apply it onto the miniature. Now, this is something to bear in mind. So long as the transfer stays wet, you can keep on moving it around. So you can take as long as you need to get the transfer in position, so long as you keep the model wet where the transfer is going to go. So that's the first thing that we need to do. Just load up your brush with a little bit of water again, and then paint this over where it's going to be. So on the side of the turret, just here, there, like that. Then we just got to slide the transfer into position. So here's the fiddly bit again of handling the paper. There we go. Hold it over where the transfer is going to go. And then using your brush, you just need to slide it down onto the model like this. There we go. And then we can take our time just moving it into position. So here you go, you see, because the transfer is still wet, I can easily move it around. So just decide where you want it to be, around about there, and just take your time slowly pushing it into position. Once you're happy with that, then you just need to go to your tissue and use it just to soak away the excess water by just gently dabbing like this, pushing that transfer down onto the model. Once the area is dry, we're ready for the final stage, which is to seal down the transfer to make sure it doesn't get scratched or damaged by accident. And for this, we're going to need Storm Shield, so the matte varnish. And this will also matte down that gloss area as well. Now, once again, I'm going to use the medium shade brush to apply it. And as with Ardcoat, you want to use the palette here just to check to see how thick the paint is and see if you need to water it down any. But this looks good to me straight out the pot. So I'm just going to load up my brush with some of this. And then it's just a matter of painting it all over the area that you previously applied the gloss varnish to. And now the varnish is completely dry, the transfer is sealed down, and the process is complete. And no matter what marking you're applying to whatever model, the process is always the same. So the key things to remember about doing this are, first of all, to paint the whole area where the transfer is going to go using Ardcoat gloss varnish to ensure you've got a nice smooth surface for the transfer to adhere to. Then make sure you cut the transfer out, and if you're using a knife, do be careful. If you're a youngster, get an adult to do this for you. Remember, so long as the transfer stays wet, you can keep on moving it around, so you can use this to take as long as you want to get it into position. And once you've dried it, use Storm Shield to seal it down to make sure it doesn't get scratched off. But there you go. That's all you need to know about applying transfers. We really hope you have fun using them, and we'll see you all again soon.